Hey, it's Alex from iFixit. If you're replacing the display on your iPhone 6s or later, you're going to want to replace adhesive strips that keep your phone water resistant. But before you dive in, there are a few things you're going to need to take care of. For this repair, you'll need tweezers, a spudger, isopropyl alcohol with some swabs, a stack of coins, a heat gun, adhesive for your model phone, and check out our guides for any other tools you'll need to open your specific device. Carefully peel off all the old adhesive with some tweezers and a spudger. Then apply a little bit of isopropyl alcohol to clean off any residue. To reapply the adhesive strips, begin by peeling the backing off, starting with the large blue tab. Carefully align the exposed lower adhesive strip with the bottom edge of your iPhone's case. Be very careful here. Once the adhesive is pressed into place, you won't be able to reposition it, and you'll have to remove it and start over with a new adhesive strip. When you have it correctly aligned, gently press the exposed strip into place. Next, we'll continue by peeling the backing away and gently pressing the adhesive into place. If you've correctly aligned the lower edge, the sides and top edges will fall perfectly into place. If you mess up and don't have an extra adhesive strip on hand, it's fine to reassemble your iPhone without the adhesive in place. Just keep in mind your iPhone's water resistance will be compromised. With the adhesive in place, use a spudger to gently press the adhesive into position. Just make sure you're not pressing on any of the internal components. Now grab the small tab and peel it back to separate the large front liner from the adhesive. It's time to reassemble your phone. Once you've reconnected your display cables and reconnected the battery, replace both of your brackets. Then, take a moment to power your phone on and make sure to test it's working perfectly. Make sure your entire screen is recognizing touch and display powers on and looks A-OK. Once you're sure everything is working great, go ahead and remove the final release liners exposing the adhesive. Do your best not to touch the exposed adhesive. Slide the top of your iPhone into position, making sure the tabs fit into place just underneath the top edge of the iPhone's case. Then lower the display, making sure all cables are clear and not being pinched by the display and case. With your iPhone closed up, we need to make sure the adhesive bonds correctly. So essentially what we're going to do is activate the adhesive with a little bit of heat and then use pressure to get everything firmly sealed. But we have a little bit of a complication. The camera bump makes it so you won't be able to apply even pressure, but we have a 20-something cent solution. We're going to line the perimeter of the phone with some pennies or coin of your choice, and then use a heat gun or hairdryer to heat up the back of the phone until it's hot to the touch. Then we're going to stack 4 or 5 of our heaviest books squarely on top of the phone. Leave them in place for about 30 minutes for the adhesive to set. Then go ahead and take them off and pick up your iPhone. All right, if everything went like it should, you've now restored your iPhone's water resistance. Good job on your repair, and we'll see you next time.